Stella, Splash, Simba, Hydrox, Ditto, and Boo. The Lucky Ferals.
Hey everyone, I wanted to post a real-time update about Ditto. I was going to wait until tomorrow. Tomorrow is 60 days inside, so the last real-time update was day 50, and I thought I'd wait until day 60, but I'm gonna post it today. Today is day 59, and I wanted to talk about a few things. So, right now, Ditto, he just had some lunch, and he's back on antibiotics. So he is on Veriflox, which is the antibiotic that he was originally on back in May of 2021, May of this past year, when I was able to get him into a trap and get him to the animal hospital for the first time because of his leg wound. He was limping and he had an abscess wound on his leg, a puncture wound. And the vet put him on the Veriflox. And he did well on that. He was on that for 10 days. And after he was on the Veriflox, that's when he had the bloody nose for a while. And then I was researching and I found out that for Veriflox, cats should be on it for 7 days. And if they're on it longer than 7 days, it could cause some blood issues, and his nosebleeds could have been caused as a side effect of being on it for 10 days. But he did well on it, and it solved his problem with his leg, and the swelling went down, and everything was fine. And then over the summer, right around the time that Hydrox passed, Ditto was limping again, and he had a swollen shoulder. And I had a refill on the Veriflox from the first prescription. So I had it refilled at the animal hospital. And he took it again. He took it for 7 days. And during that time, the abscess that he had drained, like it burst and it drained and it cleared up. So what I did was I called up the vet that saw him most recently, the holistic vet that I took him to. Actually, I emailed the vet and I explained the situation that Ditto had been on the Veriflox twice before for abscesses and it worked. And maybe if this is an abscess, it could work on his swelling. Even if it's not an abscess, if he does have some sort of like secondary infection or something like that, it could work on it or it could at least help it. So he wrote a prescription and it just arrived today. I had to order it online. And it took a few days to get here. And it just got here a little while ago, and Ditto had it in his lunch. So Ditto's been on 3 meals a day. For a while, he was on the 1 big meal a day, but then I decided it's probably better for him to be on smaller meals because he was hungry at night. And I also noticed that sometimes his mouth would not bleed if he only ate like 1 or 2 plates of food. And if he ate more than that, sometimes that would aggravate his mouth. So right now he seems to be doing better on multiple smaller meals. So he's been doing like 3 smaller meals a day, like breakfast, lunch, and dinner. So he had a big breakfast today. He's eating well. He's eating very well. And he just had lunch and I put the Veriflox in his lunch and he devoured his lunch. So we are going to be very hopeful that the Veriflox can help him. His eye is still inflamed. It's worse than it was 10 days ago. So that seems to be progressing. If it is an eye infection, I'm very hopeful that the Veriflox will work for it. I was trying to put some drops in his eyes. I have the Veterison eye wash and he freaked out when I put that in his eye or when I tried to. I was successful once or twice, but then he like really became afraid of me and I didn't want that. A few people have told me I can use colloidal silver as eye drops. I tried that too. He just freaks out if I go anywhere near his eye. I mean, he can still see out of it because he can see me coming toward that side of his head. I also have some terramycin ointment that is the typical treatment that vets give for eye infections. You put a little bit in the eye, and when I've tried to do that, no matter how I've tried to do that, he doesn't let me do that either. So let's be really hopeful and positive that these antibiotics can help for him. So I just wanted to mention that. So today he's starting a new course of treatment. He's still on lots of natural supplements. He's getting so much nutrition in his food every day. So I'm hoping that, you know, continues to build his health. But I am exploring all possibilities. I'm not giving up on him. He's still doing well, other than the swelling and the occasional mouth pain, the occasional mouth bleeding, and then this eye issue. He's doing really well, and he absolutely loves being a house cat and spending time with me, and I would really like to see him get better. So please continue to send positive energy his way. He needs all the help he can get. And what I have here is the notebook that I started for him back in May, and it's really helpful to be able to look back at this and see how things progressed for him and what he ate and what he was treated with. So this is just a regular composition book. I really like that it had black cats on it. When I see really nice cat related notebooks and stuff, I usually buy a few and so that I have them, but I thought that looked like Boo a lot. So this is what I do for the cats whenever they're on any kind of medications or treatments or protocols or anything like that. I start a notebook for them, or I continue a notebook that I've already started for them. In this case, this was brand new for Ditto. This was Friday, May 14th, 2021. This was day one. For breakfast, which he had about 9 a.m., he had 1.3 milliliters of Veriflox, and that's what he's on now. That's what he started today. He also had gabapentin 100 milligram capsule at that time, and it was in food, homemade raw, and he also had half of a churu with that, and it said he ate well. I gave him a second plate of food, homemade raw scoop, and half of a churu. So basically what I do is I keep notes on everything that he eats, how well he eats it, all the medicines that he consumes, and just general observations about his behavior. And it's really, really helpful to do this if you have a cat that's sick or if you have a cat on medicine, because this is really great to look back on if you have another health issue in the future. It's really helpful to look back on this and see what kind of progress he made and when he made the progress. So I just look through this to see how he did on Veriflox. So on day one, he started taking the Veriflox. And then here we can see on day five, it said he stretched this morning and is more mobile on his leg. So by day five, we were seeing some results from the medicines that he was on. So it didn't happen the first day. Back then it was day five. On day six, I wrote, looking at the security camera, he appears to be stretching much more and to not be limping. So it was 6 days until he stopped limping. Again, if I did not write this down, I would not remember exactly what day it was that he really started to show improvement. And then here on the bottom of the page, it says arm less swollen. So I didn't notice swelling going down until day six. Here's the page for August 2nd, 2021. There was a lot going on with the cats at that time. And that was the day that Hydrox was taken to the animal hospital for the final time. That was the day she passed on. And I didn't mention anything else that was going on at the time because really the main focus was on Hydrox. But Simba had been sick. Simba had some kind of sore below his nose, and I was treating him for that. So it actually started earlier than that. On August 1st, I wrote, Simba has been laying in a round cat bed downstairs all day. He looks like he has some kind of scab or sore below his nose. And then I gave him some herbs and supplements with dinner and a snack. And then on August 2nd, Ditto was limping. Now, Ditto had also started limping a few days before that, but my main concern was about Hydrox. Hydrox was all of my attention, and Ditto had been limping before, so his limping was secondary. I had also been giving Ditto some natural supplements and some herbs. So Simba had a sore below his nose, some drool, smelly breath, and I gave him some supplements also. Then on August 3rd, the day after Hydrox had passed, Ditto was still limping, and he was really hot. I thought maybe he had a fever, which would indicate an infection. So I had the Veriflox refilled. The original prescription had a refill on it, so I had it refilled. And he started it on August 3rd. I put it in some baby food for him. And I was trying to trap him at that time. It was not successful, but I tried. Simba also continued to be on some natural supplements, and with Simba's issue, that was able to clear up on natural supplements. And this time, when Ditto was on day 4 of the Veriflox, that's when I noticed changes in his abscess. He had a big swollen shoulder, he had what looked like a puncture wound and an abscess. So here, on day 4 of the Veriflox, I wrote, his paw swollen, abscess is draining, pus running down leg. It was horrible, and appears to not be limping as much, and he also didn't feel like he had a fever. So that was on day 4 of Veriflox, after being on herbs and natural supplements for a while. And that was probably one of the biggest abscess wounds I've seen. The pus was literally just streaming down his leg. It was horrible, but he cleaned it up on his own. He groomed it on his own, and eventually that healed up also. And he took the Veriflox for 7 days this time. He was only on it for 7 days. So he had it in a squeeze up on day 7. He ate a big breakfast. He hung out on the patio most of the day. He ate a good dinner. He had lots and lots and lots of pets. And then Boo vomited on the sofa that day. There was a lot going on at that time. This was the craziest summer ever, and not in a good way. So because I kept these notes, and because I have this notebook for Ditto, I can now look back on how he did on this medication the 2 previous times that he's taken it. Let's hope he does as well this time on the medication. Let's hope after a few days we start seeing improvements. Maybe the swelling will go down. Let's just be very hopeful. So any hope or positive energy or positive thoughts you can send this way would be very much appreciated. And also at that time, a few days after Hydrox passed away, a few days after Ditto started on his Veriflox, and a few days after Simba had the issue with his nose, Stella had an issue with her eye. And I wrote, her eye is shut and oozing, looks like an eye infection. I wiped it with the Vetiracin. I gave her a squeeze up with lysine. I gave her some eye tincture and heal all tincture in her food. Then I also remember that I called my vet, and I spoke to the vet tech, and he said it didn't sound good because she couldn't open her eye and that she should be checked out right away. But unfortunately, they cannot do it because my vet was having his own family emergency that day. So I took her to a local animal hospital. What they found was that she had a cut inside of her eyelid, and they put her on a 2-week antibiotic injection, the Convenia shot that they often use for cats. And they gave me the terramycin eye ointment prescription, which I had to put in Stella's eye for several days. And then she came home and she ate dinner. She had raw food, the eye tincture, heal all, meaty stick, and crunchies. I wrote down what she ate. The next day, her eye was still oozy and crusty. I put the terramycin in. And later in the day, her eye started to look a little bit better. And that was the same day that Ditto's abscess started draining and the pus was running down his leg. So there was a lot going on at that time. And then on August 7th, I don't know if you guys remember this, but the first time Ditto came inside, the vet told me that the wound on his leg could drain down to his paw, and not to be worried if the paw gets all swollen. It just means his infection is draining. And that's what happened on day 5 of the Veriflox last time. It said his leg looks better, his paw is not swollen, abscess has drained. So his paw actually must have been swollen the day or two before that. And it also says big open wound, but it looks like he's been cleaning it. And he took really, really good care of that wound. I remember that. And I do remember seeing him with the giant swollen paw when he was outside and thinking, okay, that's what the vet said would happen. So this is a good indication that he's healing. And on that day, Stella's eye started looking better and more open. And then Stella healed really, really fast, because it was the following day that her eye started looking okay. So it was just a few days of putting terramycin in Stella's eye, making sure she got lots of rest, good nutrition, and you know, just trying to keep her away from any of the other cats who could swat at her, and she did fine. So she got through that really fine. And here's Ditto. He's hanging out by the windows in his room. I was going to show you him laying under the day sofa, but I guess he wanted to get out from under there and get some air. The window's been open all day because it's such a beautiful day out. and he's smelling the air. So one other thing that I wanted to mention is that YouTube has been deleting comments on some of the recent videos on this channel. And I was reading a comment from Elaine Kubiak earlier today. So she left a comment and it got held for review. What that means is when someone leaves a comment, YouTube scans through the words on the comment and based on their algorithms and their censorship, they will usually hold comments for review instead of approving them right away if they think something might be a little bit off with the comment or they're concerned about the content of the comment. So I read the comment and it was a very, very helpful comment full of really good information and I approved the comment. And then when I went back to reply to it, the comment wasn't there. It got deleted and I did not delete it because I know the difference between deleting a comment and approving a comment. And I know I definitely approved the comment and I was really looking forward to getting back to her and saying, thank you, I'm actually using what you sent, and I'm really happy that you sent it, and thank you for the information. Unfortunately, I did not get to do that because YouTube deleted the comment. And I've had other people tell me that they've tried to leave comments, and the comments disappeared also, and they had to kind of rewrite their comments, just changing the words that they were using. So I just wanted to point that out to people, because if you see that happen, if you leave a comment on one of the videos, and you see that the comment disappears, just try to reword it, try to misspell some words, anything related to like a disease or an illness or a medicine. That seems to be what they're deleting comments with or censoring out. So if we're talking about a specific illness or a medication or a treatment, just try to misspell it or something like that so I'll still know what it is, but it won't get caught by their censoring system. And I want to thank everyone who's left really helpful comments. I'm definitely open to all possibilities when it comes to helping Ditto. I am not going to give up on him. And I am going to be very hopeful that he continues to make good progress. He's still swollen. His eye is really inflamed, but he is a really, really good patient. You're doing really good, Ditto. Let's hope that he continues to do really good and that we can find a course of treatment that will make him feel a whole lot better and restore him to full health.
Thank you for watching this Lucky Pearls video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe if you'd like me to post more videos, and please make sure to check out these other videos that were selected especially for you.